Hi, I'm Carly Beaver, and welcome to another episode of Energy Savers, the show where Calgary energy experts give you the inside scoop on saving energy in your home. Today I'm here with climate and energy specialist Corey Dufresne to talk about your home's building envelope, the part that keeps the outside from getting in. So Corey, can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Sure, Carly. I'm an energy efficiency expert in building envelopes. So it really means that we look at homes, windows, doors, insulation, and vapor barrier in order to make sure that we keep the outside out and the inside in.
So can you explain to us what makes up your building envelope?
Yeah, your home's building envelope is really the walls, the windows, the doors, and the insulation. And the key to understanding your energy efficiency in your home is really understanding your building envelope.
So, what are the most important things about your building envelope?
A good building envelope will actually provide proper levels of insulation, adequate energy efficient windows and doors, and it will really focus on making sure that you have proper air sealing. That'll help with issues like airflow through your home, dust coming into your home, and keeping the moisture out as well. Key step in improving the energy efficiency of your home really boils down to making sure you have the understanding of your building envelope.
So, why is your home's building envelope important for energy efficiency?
If you have a poorly insulated home, you'll actually require more energy for heating and cooling, which will lead to you not only spending more money on your home bills, but also will require you to potentially have an oversized HVAC system. With a good building envelope, you'll save yourself money on your energy bills and on the cost of the HVAC system itself.
Thinking about insulation now, what types are available for homeowners?
There's many types of insulation that are actually available for homeowners. The most common one is pink bat insulation, which most people have seen. There's rigid board insulation, which is more common for exterior home renovations. There's blown-in insulation that you can put in your attic. Spray foam, which is stuff that kind of goes around the doors to seal that building envelope. It just depends on the area of your home where you're talking about adding insulation. One of the key things that we can do nowadays is when you're looking at renovations to the exterior of your home, replacing that siding, you can look at adding rigid board insulation to the outside of your home.
What's your advice for homeowners who don't really know where to start?
Talking with an energy advisor is a great place to start. They'll come in and actually do a full assessment of your home and look at the actual building envelope, the levels of insulation, and they'll recommend specific projects that you can do for your individual home to make it more energy efficient. Working with a qualified contractor will help you get the right type of insulation for your home and really pull through on making sure you have an appropriate building envelope. I understand the Clean Energy Improvement Program actually is helpful in homeowners accessing funds to get these projects off the ground.
Yeah, the Clean Energy Improvement Program will provide financing for a variety of building envelope projects, including interior insulation, so like in your walls or your attic, exterior insulation, windows, doors, air sealing, a lot of different types of building envelope projects. The Clean Energy Improvement Program is really a great program for all homeowners doing renovations. Thank you so much, Corey. That's great information for homeowners. And that's it for another episode of Energy Savers. For more information on how to apply to the Clean Energy Improvement Program, you can visit calgary.ca/CEIP, and we'll see you next time.